You're holding my peach. So? So it's mine. The peach in your hand.
Sorry.
You are not sorry. But you will be.
Oh, really?
What?
What are you gonna do about it?
What are you, deaf?
No. Just thinking of all the things I'm going to do about it. Oh, look. My peach.
Dr. Hanover is out of the office till later this afternoon. He should like to leave a number where
you don't mind, I'd prefer to wait here.
He'll be gone sometime.
You just said he'd return in the afternoon.
It could be longer.
Well, then it could be shorter. By your own logic.
Up to a little hanky-panky, are we?
You run a roadside motel, madam. You traffic in hanky-panky.
I run an honest business.
Well, then I suppose you shouldn't stick your nose where it doesn't belong.
Dinner?
Yes, Nurse Bucket. It's a meal. Many people enjoy them. Smile like that could melt ice.
So I've been told.
Well, I don't like it. A lady in my position could go so far as to say you're leering.
I refuse to wear this! My entire backside will be exposed!
Any glimpse of your backside, Mr. Bromley, will be brief, as it would cause even the most hardened observer to promptly avert their eyes.
What is it you want?
Your job. And since there aren't any positions available, I have been forced to create one myself. If it were ever to get out that there were deaths at the hospital.
Are you blackmailing me?
I know where the bodies are buried. Oh, please don't put your hand on me like that. Thank you. Dr. Hanover is a dope fiend and a basket case who doesn't deserve someone like you. Because you wake up every morning, and without even trying, you are tenacious, clever, and wise. You are 1,000 wonderful things that that walking pile of garbage will never be. Do you hear me?
I am your superior.
Of that, you are very, very mistaken.
You should thank your lucky stars these men didn't blow your head off. It's far more mercy than I would have shown you.
You're going to tell me that I betrayed you. And that you're coming for me. And that I should be very afraid. Well, let me tell you something, little brother. You are the one who should be afraid.
Oh, how I wish we could rid this hospital of vermin.
If I were you, I would choose my next words very carefully. You should bathe more often. Your fingernails are filthy.